Yeah. I mean, I literally just walked into what seems to be a portal, probably to head to a lower floor, unless it was to a higher floor. I think it was to a lower floor, like this green portal here, and I just randomly wraiths randomly spawned. Yeah, this is to go higher, not lower. So wraiths just randomly spawned in front of me and killed me as soon as I entered the floor. Arena. These are the areas where I wish that the game could have been much more polished than it already is. Finally, a level of experience. At least all the swinging around is paying off. Okay, let's see here. Endurance is 69. Nice. Do I want to increase my willpower? Yes, I do. Okay, and 1-2 endurance. I don't really need to increase my agility any further. Do I want to increase my luck a little? Or would I like to increase my speed a little? I guess increasing my speed won't exactly hurt. Huh. Magic defense plus 4. That sounds like a nice and promising. Nah. Speed. Let's hope it helps. Let us hope it helps. Let's just use a potion of heal true. So this is a side effect of playing the game in like during the later levels, is that you just constantly keep on edge. You never really know when something is going to come out and attack you. And yeah, I guess that's just one of the things about playing this game. So I guess we found one of the ways that, you know, we could have come up, and I'm guessing that the entrance to the next floor is also in the center of this level, because I don't really think it would make sense otherwise. See, my health is much higher now just because of a few points that were misplaced. At least you can still run from enemies in the game, otherwise the game would have been so much more difficult. So these seem to be individual rooms, bedchambers, quarters. If the enemies in this level were not as difficult as they are, this game would have been this level would have been so much more easier to complete. But it's because of the countless number of Medusas and the wraiths and the vampires and the liches that this level is as difficult as it is. Because I mean, this game could have been much easier. Wow, 2-3 at a time, huh? Looks like I am in the middle of a gangbang. 4 at a time. Well, I guess you can officially call this a gangbang. They are fucking me up. You know, I have never had to pause this many times before. And yeah, I think these guys are just made a little more difficult. I've been swinging at the ear for a while there. Yeah. These guys just have been made more difficult in general. Simply because, I mean, they're doing much more damage and they're taking much more hits to go down now. So, yeah. Okay, only one way to go. My guess is that the entrance to the next floor is somewhere here. At least I hope it is. And I hope I did save, so if I didn't, well, might as well now. Okay. I can hear what seems to be a hellhound of sorts. And that is honestly the last thing that I wish to hear. Whatever that was. I'm not too eager to stay around and find out, if you get my meaning. Primarily because these guys are savage. What was that sound? I mean, is that sound like a sort of signal that I'm nearing the... Looks like I just have got no choice but to actually send and face them. Huh. Let's see here, one entrance here, one entrance here. And there could be more entrances over there and there, but let's see. If I didn't take a wrong turn, which I do not think that I did, I should be on the right path. But you never know, it may just be that the first turn itself that I took was a wrong turn. Hellhound, that's what I could hear back then. This is a... No, this is a short room, not a long one. Since I did survive that encounter, might as well save here. Another stone golem. Time to take this slow and kill all the enemies that we come across, because this game is going to be very difficult otherwise. You know, another thing that I do believe is causing me 112 gold pieces, amazing, is causing me difficulties is the fact that I'm playing with a broadsword instead of a longsword. Maybe I'll try switching up the weapons and see whether it helps. How much durability do I have on the broadsword here? Slightly used, and I no, not the adamantium longsword. I'll keep the broadsword as a like a backup weapon, and just equip the longsword instead, because, well, the longsword is frankly more powerful than the broadsword is. So yeah, well, we can try going this way and see what awaits us here, but as it would appear, not a lot. This place seems closed off. Who is shooting what at me? Okay, wait. Is there somebody on top of me? Who is shooting what at me? From where? Who attacks me? Wait, was that... Oh, it was a secret door. And there was somebody there. Somebody I could neither see nor hit. We seem to be in the clear. I guess I'll save here. And yeah, this wasn't a hidden door? How strange. How strange indeed. I just hope that the entrance wasn't somewhere here, and I completely missed it. Well, even if it was, this place isn't exactly the largest thing around, so yeah, we'll get around to the entrance. Sooner rather than later, I hope. This seems like another way to... the exit, like this one here. It's like the path to the previous floor. Do we want to check it out? I guess we do. I can already hear a hellhound. I see. Interesting. Quite interesting, to be honest. This place doesn't really seem to have much, but tell you what, I'll make a save point, an additional save point, do not touch, right here, and I'll continue exploring from this point onwards. I want to check this place out. It may be that the entrance to the next floor was right there, so yeah. Oh, that's what was making those sounds. He was stalking me. I have a stalker. That's probably nothing to be proud of, but yeah. There is a secret door here. This place looks a little different. Nothing but a wall here. Hopefully, you know what? Yeah. Time to shift both hands to the keyboard. Okay, open that up. Huh. You know what, let's just clear this out. Let's just clear this place out and see where this goes, where this path takes us. So, yeah. Okay. Let's go down here. Let's see what this place holds for us. I'm glad that you did not attack when you had the chance to do so. Probably nothing, but it doesn't hurt to check, does it? Except for a few hellhounds. Yeah, nothing here. So this side is empty. I'm guessing then the entrance is somewhere located somewhere up top. So let us make our way back then. Oh, wait. 7 gold pieces. A bracelet. Thank you very much. And I'm going back. Do not disturb me. I do not care who you are or where you're coming from. I will not be fighting you. Vampire is regenerating and I do not give a fuck. Because I'm getting out of here. The worst part about vampires is that they can see you through darkness. I believe I've already told you guys this, but yeah, they can see you through darkness. And it literally does not matter where are all these creatures coming from. Are they like spawning randomly? Because I literally cleared this path out. There should be no one here. But apparently there are. There are people here. Out here to kill me. So anyway. Okay. I guess I'll just update this slot here. I mean, I made that slot just for like assuredly safe places, like places where I'm in doubt, places where I don't know whether I want to go any further or not. I mean, the places where I'm taking a crossroad. So if something happens and I die and I find out that the place is not worth exploring, then I would basically go back to the safe to explore more. I'm a little lazy that way. I don't exactly want to make my way back, especially from the most recent save. So, we found it. Ladies and gentlemen, we have found the way down. Probably should have saved it in the dungeon escape save, like the save I made outside. But then again, we've got like so many save slots already, do we really need to? I guess the answer is no, we do not. The fact that you can walk in this game as fast as you can is a little bit disconcerting. Okay, this seems to be a small dungeon, but there's like lava on the other side, and that's a little strange. I mean, I can literally see a wall here, but I can also see lava here, so fuck. Okay, time to pop in a potion of resist shock and hope that Lich can't find you. Okay, there's a tunnel here which we can use. I guess I'll save the game here and like climb up into this niche if possible. I can't climb up there, okay. I guess this is supposed to be like an indestructible wall of sorts. And what's on the other side? Okay, fine, we don't need to get stuck in there. The most frustrating part of this oh my god, delicious! Two liches. I don't know how you say them, but fuck them. Like, two of them at a time. No, I cannot handle two. I can only handle one at most. Well, let's see. You gotta do it now, don't we? And I cut it a little close there. Way too close, actually. With liches, you don't want to go less than half health, because they will... They are capable of decreasing half your health in one hit. So, one of them. So, yeah, you basically want to keep your health high. The problem with liches is they can see you when you're invisible, so... Yeah, you really need to come prepared. This might make a good screenshot. This honestly might. Are we safe? I guess. Time to update the save slot, and wow, that was something. Do I want to clear this area out first? I think I do. So, yeah, I mean, I just did load up a save, so... Yeah, let's use a potion of... stamina. Where did the potion of stamina go? Right here, yeah. Liches. More liches? At least they're liches. Liches are bitches. So, which devil would I rather prefer to go to? The one here, or the one here? Man! I can hear more, but let's hope they aren't in pairs or trios. Let's hope they're alone. So, my god, talk about a battery. Middle of nowhere. I guess this is what you would call a well-earned victory then. Ah, man, that was rough. I guess we can try heading this way? Because, I mean, none of the levels are great, like, have more than 4 floors in the arena, that much I do know. So, you know what, fuck you. At least it's just one of you guys this time around. Like, not like a whole bunch of you, so... And what did I want to do? Yeah, pushing the prisoner's shock. Heal true, where did heal true go? Right here. Pushing the prisoner's shock. Potion of heal true. I think I'll use the ring of healing as well. Fucking hell, man. What's with Jagar Tharn and all the liches? Did he literally like raise the undead army against me? And train them in the arts of mysticism, specifically in the School of Destruction? This was rough. This was fucking rough. I guess that what we see in front of us is a way to enter this great lava room thingy. No, it isn't. Fuck that. You know what? Here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna stay there with your lich buddy while I get the fuck off. Okay, no. Bad liches. I know you're doing a good job, but bad liches. Oh my god, having to... This game literally makes me wish I had three hands. It honestly does. It honestly makes me wish I had three hands instead. My fucking god. And I hope there aren't any more behind me. Because I am quickly running out of potions. My god. Can you please die soon? At least I'm missing the spells now. Wouldn't be wrong in assuming that I'm safe for the moment. Well, that probably did us some good. Man. That was difficult. Not gonna lie, that was very, very difficult. And the most frustrating part is, even if you're invisible like this, they will still see you. Liches always, always know where you are. Where are we going? I guess this is the way in, I suppose. I see. It probably is the way in. Before you stands a great seal, though the surface is hot as if behind lies a great fire. A spot of sulfur and brimstone hangs in the still dead air. I guess it's time to use like a potion of levitation. Yep, it's a whole room of lava in front of us. It's a sea of lava, in fact. Okay, oh wait, that was Jagar Tharn. Yes. Time to pop in a potion of levitation. Wait, how many potions of heal true do we have at this moment? Probably 100? I hope it's not below 100. 144. I guess we'll make do with that. And this is Jagar Tharn here. We have finally come to face off with Jagar Tharn. And the dude really isn't all that difficult in melee range. I like him. I can hear a lot of things around me, like hellhounds and stuff. Are we hitting him? I don't know. Can't really tell. I hope we are. Mark of Firestorm.
3 hours later.
I don't really think I'm making contact. Do I really want to continue trying to kill this guy? I don't know, I mean, let's see. It'll be a miracle if I pick this lock, so apparently this is the key that I have to pick. And there's a jewel door here, which I need to go to. Okay, holds up. Heal true again. This guy is hitting very hard. Okay, wish me luck, guys. I might die here. And yeah. Potion of resist fire. You open the door with a mithril key. Ah, so that's it. Free action. You must not! The jewel holds my life force! Thou art truly a child of the Empire. I thank thee for thy assistance. It seems, Grimfangs, that I am quite in the way. Not only have you managed to save the Emperor, but my life as well. I cannot be but proud of one who has truly earned such renown. And my deepest respect. Who are you, though? I have a particular idea as to the question of your service in mind. From this day forth, thou art named the Eternal Champion. From thy hand shall be dealt the needs of the Empire. I, Uriel Septim, true Emperor of Tamriel, do decree and thus make law. Arise, my champion, and take thy rightful place at my side. You have proven yourself a worthy champion of the Empire, and such service shall not easily be forgotten. Hang not your sword above the mantle, place not your spellbook upon the shelves. Many such adventures still await your hand. This was but one chapter in the story of the Elder Scrolls. Whew. That was stressful. I am silenced, I am poisoned, I am resistant to fire. What the hell, man? Whew, I guess purification should help with all that. I'm a non-target, resistant to fire, silenced. I guess I'll just need to go ahead and get blessed then. Okay, cure poison. Hold up. I still am resistant to fire and non-target. Let me just save the game right here, because we are officially done with the game, ladies and gentlemen. This is the place, the palace gates. If you click on this now... Oh wait, those are the city gates. My bad. So yeah, that was the end of the game, and if you try and go ahead and get back to the palace now, you'll notice that the guard will say that the palace is closed for repairs because of all the havoc we wreaked there. Okay, so anyway, if you try and click the palace again, as you approach the palace gates, a guard respectfully bows and informs you that due to the catastrophic forces unleashed during the final conflict with the Imperial Battle Mage, the palace is currently under reconstruction. Perhaps he suggests you could return once the repairs are complete. And that marks the end of the journey for us fellow Earthlings, at least as far as the Elder Scrolls Arena is concerned. Now, it shall not be the end for me, and for your Twitch streamers as well, because I do not believe that I did a good job of recording the gameplay for the first few episodes, especially up until where I did not have my DOSBox properly configured and it was basically running slow. So what I want to do next is basically what I want to do is create a new character and just cover the videos up until where I reach like a random part of Fanglir and just leave it there, and old me will carry on the rest. So I do want to make things better. Excuse me. I want to make sure that things are done right this time around. I'm thinking I would choose a play. A spellcaster class this time, but then again, I don't really know how much that will help. Especially considering the fact that spells can be randomized, and spellcasters in beginning are they just absolutely suck. So yeah, what's it, 5:39 in the afternoon, works for me, and thank you for staying there and keeping me company, young woman. Why are you black? I have no idea. So you should be a Breton, like, maybe, I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, that's pretty much what I want to do, and that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.